Take us through just the journey to this fight. How long it took to kind of set up, and just what happened recently, I guess.
Yeah, so this has been a crazy few weeks. I was scheduled to fight Giga Chikadze, world-class kickboxer. He was a world champion, a world-class striker, and then he got injured 10 days out from our fight. So, you know, I've been prepping, I've been preparing for December 16th. I'm fighting no matter what. My wife and I want to come back, enjoy Christmas. We have some trips planned early the year and end of January as well. So I'm fighting regardless. I don't care who they put in front of me. I'm getting my hand raised on December 16th. And the matchmakers came back with, you know, now a world-class grappler. So 10-day notice. And so I just have to kind of switch up my game plan. Like the complete 180, but it really doesn't matter. I have to focus on myself, and I just have to do me, you know. And just I've been doing this for so long, and you know, I'm well-rounded everywhere. So it's definitely a little change of plans, but you know, it's gonna work out really well. And Bryce Mitchell's a huge name. I think it's a bigger fight for sure. I think the fans are more excited for this fight, and he's a tough opponent as well.
Yeah, I agree with that. I mean, I'll get to Bryce in just a second, but take us through, for people who don't understand, the chaos, the stress of when an opponent falls out for whatever reason, what that puts on yourself.
Man, it's crazy. The stress and kind of the mind games that you play with yourself and go through, it's different. That's why I say fighting, it's even though it's a physical combat sport, I think it's an 80% mental, maybe 90% mental. You know, that's my strongest attribute. I'll stick to that. I've been saying that my whole career. There's no one that's going to mentally break me, no one that's going to just tear me down, just because I believe so strongly in myself and my capabilities. So regardless, I'm fighting December 16th. I planned on fighting one guy. They switched it up on a 10-day notice. I don't care. You know, I'm going in there. I can fight. You know, it's one thing. What if someone breaks into your house? Are you going to be ready to protect your family? I sure will. So I don't care if it's a 10-day notice, if it's a day notice. It doesn't matter. You know, I'm always ready, and I'm well prepared all the time.
The one thing that was pretty clear was that there was no shortage of people trying to step up. Saw Aljamain Sterling, several others. Did you have any doubt that you would be fighting December 16th?
No, I knew I was fighting December 16th. It's in my contract. So if the original opponent does not, he can't make it to the fight, they have to find me someone. But sometimes it doesn't work in your favor. You know, they'll try to give you some young, hungry person that they're trying to build up, or whatever it is. Someone that's just, you know, that's not there. I want to fight big name guys. I deserve to fight big name guys. I'm, you know, ranked 6th in the world, so I want a big name, and Bryce Mitchell is that big name. So a lot of people did step up. I know Aljamain Sterling, he's one of the greatest bantamweight champions of all time. He wants to come up and fight at featherweight, so when he was saying he'd be ready, I wanted that fight, you know, but it just didn't materialize.
Did some of those add up to maybe possibilities later down the road?
Yeah, possibly. You know, I feel like the guys behind me that aren't in the rankings, that are just, like I said, young, hungry, talented fighters. I think if they continue to beat guys in front of them and they beat guys in the top 10, then things can work out. But like Aljamain coming up from bantamweight to featherweight, you know, I'd gladly welcome him to the featherweight division. It would be an honor to fight one of the best bantamweights of all time. But yeah, they can happen, but I'm literally solely focused on Bryce Mitchell right now. It's a tough challenge in front of me, and I'm gonna go in there and I'm gonna get my hand raised. I'm gonna get back in the winning column and finish the year strong.
What has it been like? I mean, it's interesting in talking to you when you go on a five fight win streak versus a mentality of, okay, here I've suffered two straight losses. Does your mentality change? I mean, I know everyone's human at the end of the day, but how's that kind of compare and contrast for yourself?
Yeah, no, it's definitely going on a five fight winning streak to just coming off my first losing streak, two-fight losing streak in my entire career. It's tough. You know, I fought for the interim title, and then I just fought a guy that's fighting for the featherweight title next. You know, so I lost two fights. Good opponents. I definitely want those back. But no, my mentality is the same. You know, I just have to keep on moving forward one step at a time. And you know, everything works out for a reason and happens for a reason. And, you know, I truly believe that. So I'm just focused on myself, focus on this new opponent, and focus on getting my hand raised on December 16th.
I imagine, it's the way the division is. You have a lot of common opponents with the guy that you're going to fight, and obviously with Mitchell, and one of those guys is Andre Feely. I imagine Team Alpha here, is that kind of a resource for you to go have somebody in your club here that with your team that has had that experience against him?
Yeah, no, it always helps. You know, I feel like we have a little bit of insight. Andre Feely fought Bryce Mitchell before, and even a teammate of mine, Tyler Diamond, he lost to Bryce Mitchell on the Ultimate Fighter, the finale. So, yeah, I definitely have some insight, kind of their thoughts. They know my capabilities. They fought him, and so they're confident in myself. But I still just have to go out there and, you know, implement my game plan and just have a perfect game plan, and we'll have an easy night.
How are you feeling? I mean, compared to maybe previous recent fights coming in, is everything mentally healthy and everything kind of physically healthy as well?
Yeah, everything's just as usual. You know, it's like I'm looking forward to getting my hand raised and celebrating with friends and family. I cannot wait till that. That's like the biggest thing for me. You know, first it's the long grueling training camp, and then it's hitting the scale. I can't wait to weigh in so I can hydrate and eat, and then I'll sleep, relax, recover, and then, you know, I get to go perform on Saturday night. Once I get my hand raised, and that's when that big sense of relief is just lifted off my chest and my shoulders, and then I can have some fun and enjoy myself for a short amount of time, and then get back to it, you know, get back to work and just keep on moving forward.
So much of the focus usually in the camp is on yourself. How much is it of yourself versus your opponent? I mean, like you mentioned, you were preparing for a style that is now completely different to with Bryce Mitchell. Is it a hard pivot? Is it a reset for in camp when that happens?
Yeah, no, it's definitely it's a little bit of a challenge, you know, transitioning from a world-class striker to a world-class grappler. It's a complete 180. So it is, especially on a short notice, you know, a 9-10 day notice. So I definitely have to, what I've been preparing for, kind of switch everything up, and we're just focusing on some stuff. And I believe in my coaching staff and my team behind me, and we're gonna get the job done.
What do you see in Bryce Mitchell?
He's a talented grappler. You know, he's relentless with the takedowns. He's gonna keep coming forward. There's no quitting the guy either. You know, he's just gonna be relentless with takedowns. So I feel like once I stuff a few takedowns, maybe I hit him or crack him really hard a few times, he's gonna know that he's in for a serious fight. And I'm gonna do whatever it takes to get my hand raised, whether I knock him out in the first round or I win a unanimous decision, 3-round fight, it doesn't matter, I will get my hand raised.
Your power is pretty unique within not only the sport, but within the division. Do you think he's ever seen somebody with the power that you have?
No, I don't think he's ever fought anyone like myself. I know he hasn't fought anyone with the type of power that I have. Dan Ige, great fighter. He can crack. He hits hard too, but I still feel like I hit much harder. You know, Bryce Mitchell was saying that Dan Ige, he'd never been hit by anyone so hard when he fought Dan Ige. And you guys saw what I did to Dan Ige. I dropped him in the first 30 seconds into the first round. So it's going to be a tough fight, but I'm well prepared, and I'm always up for a challenge.
I know if you're able to kind of look at a broader picture, but you mentioned being able to spend Christmas at home, and 2024 is right around the corner. What kind of lays on the horizon for you? How do you kind of goals, mentality going into another year?
Yeah, I still have the same vision and the same dreams as when I got into the sport, not just the UFC. I want to be a UFC world champion. And, I had a little bit of setbacks, but I'm right there. You know, I have to go out there, beat Bryce Mitchell first, and then I want to fight a big name, someone that's going to get me closer to that title fight. So I don't care who it is, but I want someone in the top three. I get a win there, then I'm looking at, you know, a shot with Alexander Volkanovski or a rematch against Ilya Topuria.
You're still on the prelim card, right?
Yeah, we're headlining the prelim on ESPN Plus and ESPN 2. So I'm kind of glad about that, just because I've been training for a 6:30 bout. We're going to kick off right before the pay-per-view card starts, the main card. And even though I think it's one of the bigger fights besides the two title fights, You know, it's number six versus number nine. But yeah, I like the position. I'll be at the restaurant, you know, I'm telling you, like 45 minutes after the fight, I'll do my media, and then I'll be grubbing and having fun with friends and family.
Was there discussion about possibly putting it on the pay-per-view card?
Yeah, it was definitely up in the talks. I thought for sure that we would we'd be on the pay-per-view card, and I thought we'd fight right before the first title fight, and I was like, man, I hope not, because I go to bed early. Yeah. You know, I'm usually sleeping by 9 o'clock, so I don't want to fight at 9 o'clock. And then I thought I was going to have to do more media obligations with the press conference and things like that, but I think my schedule is just as is, so I couldn't be happier about that, you know, just so I don't have to throw more things into a chaotic fight week.
Yeah, finally, I mean, this may be kind of corny, but to looking at the casual fan, I think they look at Bryce Mitchell, a name that a lot of people are obviously super excited with. Is it any way looking at this is like, maybe this might be, it's funny how kind of things play out, but this is such a fight that I think a lot of people are going to have so much interest in. From that standpoint, does it make you kind of thankful that you have a fight like this, that maybe things worked out this way?
Yeah, I feel like things happen for a reason. So, you know, it's a bigger fight, that's for sure. There's going to be much more eyes on this fight than there were with Giga and I, even though Giga is a phenomenal fighter.
Yeah.
So, a tough, talented fighter. He only has one loss in the UFC, and that's to a guy I beat. So, it was going to be a war. But yeah, I'm looking forward to it. You know, it really, I don't care who's in front of me, who I fight. I just want to get back to that title fight. And I just want to get my hand raised. I don't think people understand how bad I truly want to win this fight and keep moving forward. So I'm going to do everything I can to do that.
Appreciate you, sir.
Thank you.
Yeah, man.